Norman when they're young, who don't give up. Maybe change a little bit. Maybe, you know, soften their stances a little bit. Maybe welcome in new, more energy. But to simply give up because I didn't get what I want, honestly, don't get involved. Just get out of the way. And I know that I'm not supposed to say that. I'm supposed to say, oh, everybody should be welcome. And no, you're not. If you're dead wood in the road, just move to the side. If you're not trying to change the world, why are you involved in politics? And again, it doesn't mean you're going to agree with me, and it doesn't mean you're going to win. It just means, I pray to God, I wouldn't have given up in 1840 if there were slaves in the world. I get involved with the slavery issue in 2002 because somebody brought me a gentleman from Sudan who had been a slave. In my estimation, if you would ask me the day before that, is there slavery in the world other than, you know, sex slave, I get all that. There's some things in the world. I never in my life thought that in today's world there were people, young people, still put up on a block and sold anywhere in this world, and there are. And if you give up on something like that, it could be you. It won't be you. It might be your great-grandchildren. And shame. Never, ever give up. Win is more than you lose. And yeah, I've done both. I've won and I've lost. Winning is better. But losing, you learn something from. And if I lose in a noble cause, that's why anybody has ever run for office, I respect. Anybody who's ever been involved in a political campaign, I respect. Anybody who's donated $2 to anybody, I respect. Why? You're engaged. You're involved. Stay involved. I think it's pretty obvious. I'm still pretty angry about life. Yeah. I started out angry about life. I started out angry. And again, no one wants to hear it, and most people here are not old enough to remember it. You can't believe what Somerville was when I was growing up. What people from Somerville were treated like. What they were expected. If I walked over to Brattle Street in Cambridge, people would hide the silverware and their daughters. And I'm only half kid, not real. That's just dead ass wrong. And if you're not involved and you're not angry about something, for me it's the lack of equality in the world, and I mean across the board, lack of equal opportunity, people. If that doesn't anger you, I don't know what you're doing. Now we may have different answers to the problem, and I respect that. I still want change in this world. It's not enough. And I have to be honest. I can't tell you how much I want young people to be involved in. And not just to want it, but to be willing to work for it. Willing to do the hard work. Willing to do the grunt work. Willing to do the stuff that nobody sees, nobody really thanks you for. They don't make TV shows about it. They won't write a book about it. I just got asked the other day, again, for the 5 millionth time in my life, you know, who are my heroes? Everybody expects me to say, like, John Kennedy, I don't know who else, Abe Lincoln. That's just not it. When I tell people the truth, it's like, it's the people you don't know. It's the guys who clean this bar up at night. It's the guys you don't see. It's my grandfather. It's my father. It's my wife's family. The people you don't see. Why? They're breaking their ass. Just trying to keep it together. And no one will write a book about them. No one will sing a song about them. No one will say thank you to them. No one will tip them. And they'll still do it. They'll still struggle on. I feel the same way about anybody who does all that stuff in the shadows. Those are the people that, to me, are the real heroes of life. People you don't read about. Not the movie stars. I mean, look, I love movie stars. I do. And there's one. I love the movies. The real heroes of life are the people you never see. And the people we never get to say thank you to. For me. So for me, that anger still drives me. I still want that change. And I want the next generation and the one after that and the one after that to want have the same degree of passion. And they may have different ideas of what that change should be, and I respect that. But whatever it is, don't give up. Ever. Accept defeat. Expect it and accept it. But get back to work the next day, because the next day opens another opportunity.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Capuano. Well, just another reminder, we are taking donations to the Boston Institute of Nonprofit Journalism. After a short break, we are going to be back with our next speaker, Gabel Eames.